Let me generalize this idea of average speed. So average speed from time one to time two, some time interval along your journey, is just the distance you traveled during that time interval from time one to time two, divided by how long that time took, this final time minus the initial time. It's still a distance over a time. And this distance is how long, how far you traveled during this time. Okay, so the problem with this is we still haven't answered the question. How fast were you going exactly 10 minutes into the ride? So the question is, how fast were you going exactly 10 minutes into your ride? Not what's your average speed from 9 to 11, but at exactly t equals 10, what is your speed? Well, we know how to calculate the speed using this formula, but this formula requires two times, and we're really only given one. So this is over some time interval from t1 to t2, but I want to know the time at exactly 10. So we're in a little bit of a bind, and calculus and this idea of a derivative is going to get us out of the bind. So here's what we do. We take a time interval, maybe from t equals 10 to t equals 11. And then we calculate the average speed for that. So we might say that the speed at exactly t equals 10 is the average speed from t equals 10 to t equals 11. But you might object and say, well, this can't be right because the speed might be changing. Maybe you're speeding up or slowing down a lot as you go from minute 10 to minute 11. So this really isn't your speed at exactly t equals 10. This could be changing. This is not an accurate way of looking at it. So that's a reasonable objection, actually. And here's one way we could address it. We could say, okay, yeah, you're right. The speed might be changing from 10 to 11. So what if I consider a smaller interval? I'll go from 10 to 10.1. That's just a tenth of a minute. Surely the speed isn't changing much. And then, so the average speed is a good approximation to the speed exactly at t equals 10. And you might object again. Well, how do you know? Maybe there's you're speeding up or slowing down a lot. Maybe you stopped for just an instant in here, and so that this average speed is not a good representation, is not a good approximation to this exact speed. Okay, well, that's again a reasonable objection. So, all right, fine. I'll try this. Maybe I'll just calculate the average speed from t equals 10 to 10.01. And again, you might object, well, it's, yes, this is a really small time interval, but still, your speed could be changing in this time interval, so it's not a good approximation or representation of the speed at this particular instant. So again, I could meet this objection. And we could continue arguing back and forth. And so on and so on and so on, considering a smaller and smaller and smaller time interval here. And so the way out of this bind, so it seems like we could play this game forever, is to agree that if the right-hand side is getting closer and closer to something, then we say that's the speed exactly at t equals 10.